all familiar with Fela, probably. Well, everybody say yeah, yeah. When I first met Alex, I said, okay, Alex, what are you going to make, man? He said, Finding Fela. Well, I'll leave it to you to decide whether he fulfilled his brief. Please enjoy the film.
One of the last discussions I had with him before he died, I asked him why his music became that long. It could go like 30 minutes nonstop, one track. He looked at me and said, and laughed and said, look, have I ever listened to Beethoven? I said, yes. Have I ever heard Bach? I said, yes. He said, did they play short music? I said, no. He said, they play what they feel. Say, what you are hearing is what I feel.
Good evening. My name is Andrew. We're going to have a Q&A. We're going to do that with Rikki Stein, but I would also like to welcome on stage somebody who was responsible for editing this movie. Lindy, where are you? Lindy Jankura. Give her a round of applause and Rikki Stein, come here. Come here. Louder! What was your biggest challenge editing this movie, working on this movie?
Well, it originally started out as a different film. I think Rikki introed that at the beginning. It was supposed to be a film about the Broadway cast and crew going back to Lagos, Nigeria. And, you know, there was over 1,000 hours of footage that I had to sort through. So that was definitely the biggest challenge, the sheer volume.
Hi, Rikki. I'm a Nigerian myself, and I'm a Dyla fan of Fela. Have you ever met him composing his music? And if so, how is it for him, for you? What do you feel?
Okay. Well, you want to know if he's ever seen him compose music,
yeah.
And then if so, what he would feel?
Yeah, okay.
Most of the creation took place during the afternoon in the shrine. There'd be 400 or 500 people sitting quietly, the real Fela aficionados, and he'd be making the song, you know, which grew out of the Yabis nights, you know, the discussions that took place with the audience would give him ideas for a song, normally to do with whatever was going on. When it came to a performance, he would tune every instrument personally. You know, he was so concerned about there being a righteous presentation of whatever it was he created.
I've actually got a chance to stumble on some video on the internet, and I saw his wife, one of his wives, describing that moment, you know. So she said, actually, when he's on top of a woman, Fela writes his song. Fucking, literally, yes. She said he actually has a paper on the side of the bed, and then he's on top of the woman, and he goes like,
I think everybody's gonna go home and try this tonight. Is this true?
I wasn't there, man.
Okay.